All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Brandon Mina. He is the CEO of BrandPilot AI. And Brandon, it's good to see you. How are you?
Thank you very much, Steve. Glad to join you here today.
Yeah, I'm excited to have you along and learn about what you're doing at the company. I know you've had some recent news out. We'll talk about that in just a second. But maybe take us inside BrandPilot. Tell us a bit about the company.
I'd love to. So, I mean, we just listed on the Canadian Securities Exchange, which is obviously the exchange for entrepreneurs. We're an AI ad tech company, and I lead a team of marketers, AI technologists, and enterprise professionals that are capable of helping you bolster your ROI through technology.
Yeah. And how do you do that?
Well, we use our proprietary technology to search and scrape social media platforms for influencers with a follower count of more than 1,000. And what we're able to do is target engaged audiences in the niches that are able to get you the eyeballs that you're looking for.
Yeah. And this is something companies have been desperately trying to do because they understand the importance of social media and marketing and how that can translate on the bottom line.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we like to say that we take a social first strategy when it comes to promoting and getting awareness out on the clients and agencies that we work with. Ultimately speaking, social has proven to be the most effective form of marketing that you can do in 2024. There's no better way to engage a captive audience, particularly when you're looking for specific niches. So to give you an example, you know, we're able to scrape the internet and find over 300 million different influencers. In a fraction of, you know, 5 or 6 clicks, we can have a short list of influencers that have the captive audience that are able to engage with the content that the brands and agencies are looking for.
So Brandon, tell me a little bit about the companies that you work with. Is your program set up to work with everyone, or do you look for specific types of companies?
So our platform is capable of servicing any and all industries. However, we've chosen specifically to work with companies in the investor relations industry. That's simply because we've curated a list and a roster of about 450 finfluencers or financial influencers that have a captive audience in that industry. Now, we've quickly branched out into financial services, healthcare, insurance, and other highly regulated industries, which is not typical for an influencer marketing platform. But we see that as a blue ocean of opportunity for us to be able to scale our revenue and work with brands that are in highly regulated industries.
Yeah, I bet you had some news out. I want to ask you about two specific. One is the launch of Spectrum IQ. Tell me a bit about this.
Yeah, so Spectrum IQ is really our flagship product. We're in the version 2, or we're in the second iteration of that product. And what it does is it gives our clients access to over 300 million different influencers out there. So we've effectively curated a database of any influencer with a follower count north of 1,000 on Instagram, Twitch, Twitter, as well as X. So we're able to very, very quickly, you know, hone in on a list of influencers that can move the needle quickly for brands and agencies alike.
Okay. And lastly, I want to ask you about, you've also started the process of eventually listing on the OTC market in the US. You're obviously in Canada right now, but I would imagine the US is a big market for you as well.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, predominantly most of our customers are coming out of the US. It's a market that we certainly want to engage investors in. And we see it as a sort of natural progression for where we're at in our growth cycle at the moment. So obviously we've listed on the CSE in the last month. You know, we've begun the process of filing to list on the OTC. And that's something we're very, very excited to move towards.
And lastly, Brandon, just what should people expect from the company for the rest of this year and beyond?
I think they can expect a lot of exciting tech releases from us. We've been very rapidly iterating on our product. We've got some really big news moving forward. We're hoping to start tackling ad fraud, waste, and abuse head on. And we've got some very exciting technology pieces that we're looking to announce in the coming months.
Well, it sounds exciting for sure. Brandon, thank you so much for giving us a little insight into what you're doing, and we appreciate your time.
Steve, thank you very much, and appreciate you.
All right, good stuff. There's Brandon Mina, the CEO of BrandPilot AI.